Association Naimisha Goswami, your welcome in online series of machine design. So in today's session we will learn about rolling contact bearing, and basically we will see their classification of rolling contact bearing, and we will see the difference between rolling contact bearing and sliding contact bearing, and what is the basic function of rolling contact bearing, why it is used. Okay, so first of all we know what is the function of bearing. So bearings are generally used for supporting action, or they provide the support to the shaft, right? When we will mount shaft, so we will use the rolling for the supporting purpose. So this is the basic function of your bearings, right? So what is rolling contact bearing? Sometimes it is also known as anti-frictional bearing. So what is the mean by anti-frictional? Anti-frictional bearing means ki there is no friction and they are having less amount, very less as compared to your sliding contact bearing. So there are basically two types of bearing. First one is your rolling contact and second one is your sliding contact bearing, and that is also known as general bearing or sleeve bearing. We have seen the design procedure and about sliding contact bearing in previous lectures, right? So in this lecture I will focus on rolling contact bearing. So basically rolling contact bearings are used, and what is the contact between when we use the rolling contact bearing? So there will may be the contact between the supporting whatever we are supporting, the supporting equipments, supporting elements, so we are supporting for the shaft. Okay, so bearings are used for the supporting purpose for the shaft, right? So there may be the contact between bearings and another element. So when the surface contact between the bearing surface is rolling instead of your sliding, means there is no surface contact, but there is only point and line contact occurs in case of your rolling contact bearing. So that's why these bearings are known as your rolling contact bearing, right? There is only point or line contact may be occur, right? So that's why these are known as your rolling contact bearing. Okay, so what is advantage of rolling contact bearing? So rolling contact bearings have low amount of coefficient of starting friction as compared to your sliding contact bearing. Okay, sliding contact bearing are having high amount of coefficient of friction, or you can say that starting coefficient of friction. As compared to that, rolling contact bearings are having very less amount of starting friction. So this is the one of the most important advantage of your rolling contact bearing, and that's why we use rolling contact bearing. So due to low coefficient of friction offered by rolling contact bearing, so these are sometimes known as anti-frictional bearing. Okay, so another name of rolling contact bearing is anti-frictional bearing. Okay, so this is also known as anti-frictional bearing. So what happens in rolling contact bearing, you can see here, walls are placed inside of your bearing, right? And these balls are having point contact, or when we use the roller in place of your balls, so they may be have the line contact. So these types of bearings are known as rolling contact bearing, which is having point contact or line contact. So we use the balls or rollers between inner race and outer race. Sometimes there may be retainer may be used to provide the or supporting for the balls or roller. Now, so when these bearings are having low starting and running friction, even at very high speed, so we can use rolling contact bearings at very high speed. Okay, and they are also able to absorb or withstand the momentary shock load. We know when we use the bearings as a supporting element in shaft, so shaft is having rotating motion and they may be withstand by your continuous cyclic loading. So when there may be your cyclic loading, so there may be fatigue, right? So they may be used, or they can withstand the momentary shock load. Okay, or these are also used for the accuracy of shaft alignment. If shaft alignment is misalignment by 2 to 3 degrees. So these bearing have the capacity that they will bring back the shaft to the original position. And in this type of bearing, we require the low cost of maintenance, and there is no lubricant is used while in service. And we have seen in sliding contact bearing, there is your lubricant is required when they are in service, right? And dimension, overall dimensions are less as compared to your sliding contact bearing, okay? And reliability of service is very, very high as compared to your sliding contact bearing. And these are easy to mount and erect, and we can easily clean the bearings. So these were the some advantages of rolling contact bearings, okay? So now there is again classification ball bearing and roller contact bearing, okay? So in this lecture I will cover about ball bearing, okay? So you can see here in this diagram, when we place the balls inside of your bearing, so these are known as ball bearing. When we use the roller in place of balls, so this bearing will be known as your roller bearing. So you can see here, there is two diagram, you can see clearly we use the balls inside of your bearing, so these are known as your ball bearing. Now, so ball and roller bearing consist of, so now what are the basic elements which by using which we can make the ball bearing or simple rolling contact bearing, okay? So in ball and roller bearing, these are consist of inner rays, okay, which is mounted on shaft. I will show the diagram, okay? You can see here in this diagram, we have inner rays, okay, and outer rays. You can see clearly in this diagram, okay, and this two inner rays, this is your inner rays and this is your outer rays. And between inner and outer rays, we have provided the some types of separator, or you can say that retainer, okay. So these are two basic elements of rolling contact bearing, okay. So when we use the ball or roller bearing, it consists of inner rays which is mounted on the shaft, okay. So inner rays will be come in contact with your shaft or journal, okay, and an outer rays which is carried by housing. So we provide the housing or casing, okay. So in between the inner and outer rays, number of balls and rollers are used, okay, and these are placed properly at equal distance. If distance between first and second ball is 1 mm, then there will be the distance between second and third ball will be 1 mm. Similarly, these are equally spaced inside of your retainer, right? So these are placed properly, right? So again, you can see in this diagram, you can better understand by using this diagram. This is your inner rays, outer rays, and retainer is provided between these two, okay? And we will place the balls or rollers in retainers at equally spaced. So this is your diagram, you can see here, and top to bottom distance is known as your outer dia, okay? Outer, you can see that outer diameter. So rolling contact bearing, so these are basically used in two parts which are assembled after balls have been properly spaced, okay? And ball bearings are used for light loads, where roller bearings are used for heavier loads, okay? So when we required bearing will be worked at low load condition, so we can use the ball bearing. And when we required there is load is very, very high, okay, so we can use the roller bearing, right? So this is the basic difference between your ball bearing and roller bearing. Again, rolling contact bearing classification. So I have already explained, these are basically classified in two of basic classification is two types. First is your ball bearing, second one is your roller bearing. There is another classification based on type of load will be applied. So what is the mean by type of load? If load, we have already seen that in sliding contact bearing, when load is applied perpendicular to the axis of rotation, for example, this is your axis of rotation and load is applying in this direction. So this is your perpendicular direction, right? So these type of bearings are known as your radial bearing, okay? For example, this is your axis of rotation and I am applying load again in this direction. So this is known as your axial, or you can say that thrust bearing, okay? So in this case, ball bearing are again classified in two fundamental. First is radial ball bearing and second one is your thrust ball bearing. Similarly, we can classify the rolling bearing, okay? When load will be act perpendicular to the axis of rotation, so this will be this may be known as radial roller bearing, and when load will be applied in the direction of axis of rotation, so these bearings are known as your thrust rolling bearing. So you can see here in diagram, or you can understand better, okay? In first diagram, in radial bearing, load is applying in perpendicular direction, and in second diagram, load is applying in same axis of rotation, okay? So these are known as radial bearing and thrust bearing. Again classification of your ball bearing. So ball bearing are classified basically four five categories, okay? So first is your deep groove ball bearing. So what is the mean by deep groove ball bearing? So balls are in deep groove ball bearing, balls are inserted into grooves, okay? We have already seen that in diagram, there is inner race, outer race, and in between inner and outer race we provide the retainer, okay? So their grooves will be provided, okay? And balls are inserted by moving the inner race. When we will rotate the inner race and we will place the ball in retainer, so this type of ball, bearings are known as your deep groove ball bearings. Again, second classification is your fling notch ball bearing. Notch means there is shape may be notch like, okay? So you can see here in this diagram, there is notch is provided, okay? Notch is provided to insert the bearings, okay? And what is the specification of these bearing? So these bearing have the high radial load carrying capacity, okay? So radial load can be increased by increasing the number of balls, okay? But thrust load of these bearings is decreases, and these are not used for the to taking the or to withstand the thrust load. These are basically used for the to carry out the or to carry the your radial loads. Next is your angular contact bearing. Angular contact bearing means there is angular contact between bearing, or you can say that in angular contact bearing have one side of outer race cut away to permit the insertion of ball. Means there is one side of the ball of the bearing will be cut in angular shape, so you can insert. In notch type of bearing, we have seen that we provide the notch like structure, right? Similarly, in case of angular contact bearing, there may be one side may be cut angularly, okay? So ball may be inserted, okay? And insertion of ball may be more than as compared to your deep groove ball bearing, okay? So you can see here angular contact bearing, you can see, okay? This is a 2D diagram of your in angular contact bearing, okay? And these bearings are used for, what is the basic function? What is the basic requirement? So these are used to take out the large axial load in one direction, okay? Or while also carrying a relatively large radial load, okay? So angular contact bearing can take your axial load as well as your radial load, okay? So you can see here radial thrust bearing or angular bearing. So you can see here, this is the angular type surface may be provided through the one side. Okay, so these are your angular contact bearing and radial bearing. So radial bearing, when your load will be at perpendicular in direction. Okay, so double row ball bearing. So double row ball bearing means when there is two row may be used. We have seen in deep groove ball bearing there is one row, right? So when we use the two rows, okay, or you can say that these bearings may be made with radial or angular contact between balls and races. Okay, so there may be contact, may be radial or angular contact. There may be any type of contact may be possible in case of double row ball bearing. Okay, and second thing is the double row ball bearing is appreciably narrower than two single row bearings. Okay, and load cap carrying capacity of these bearing are slightly less than of twice of single row bearing. Okay, simple, in simple double row means we will use the two rows, you can see here in this diagram. Next is your self alignment bearing. So self alignment bearings are used which permits the shaft deflection up to 2 to 3 degrees. Okay, when shaft is reflected 2 to 3 degrees, so this is the capacity of self aligning bearings. They may be bring back the shaft to the initial position. Okay, so in this bearing, normal clearance in ball bearing are less as because these are accommodated any appreciable misalignment of the shaft relative to your housing. Okay. So you can see in animation how it is work. Okay, when shaft is deflected at somewhat, so bearing will bring back to the original position. So this is work like this. Okay, so thank you. Keep